We are the only BSL-3 production facility in the world. We are proud to say that. Even US government doesn't have, UK government doesn't have BSL-3 production facility. I don't know why Indian companies are always targeted by everybody. So we are touching 123 countries. I come from a small agriculture family from Tamil Nadu. I don't know anything about business, or neither my family knows about business. I know only one thing is a science, nothing else I know it. And I think none of my family members are any associated with any political parties or anything. So because now the vaccine is getting into political, so I want to state that very clearly, none of them, my family members, are involved in any political families or anything else. I just, many people think, why I'm avoiding the media. I'm not a media savvy guy. I always like to find my science and ideas and work on those things. So I really not get into too much of media publicity and all that. As we go along in the phase three, we found less than 10% of side effects, adverse reaction in any of the phase three trial right now, where we have done 24,000 people vaccinated. And we got less than 10% of a side effect. And I know media, everybody's watching, every clinical center, anything in adverse reaction is there. You look at Oxford, AstraZeneca, they have given 4 grams of paracetamol for every subject were vaccinated. That means they are suppressing the adverse reaction by giving a paracetamol, whereas we have not given a paracetamol to the volunteer. So whatever the adverse reaction that is captured in the clinical trial is exactly 100%, even if it's good or bad, it's captured in 100% real time. Whereas this one, 4 grams of paracetamol is given to suppress adverse reaction. And we have done. And you look at the already publication has come out, Lancet, where the adverse reaction, allergic reaction, anaphylaxis, and a Bell palsy, all that has been reported for other vaccine, mRNA vaccines, which I don't want to talk, but you all know it very much. But I think, Covaxin phase three efficacy trial is going on. Out of 26,000 people, 25 trial sites, we have placebo control. This is probably the largest efficacy trial probably in India or even in the developing world. And it's a two-dose schedule, and we have already 24,000 people were vaccinated. And I'm proud to say that I'm really grateful to all the volunteers. In the interest of the Indian company, in the interest of the clinical research, they came forward without any financial incentive. They came forward and volunteered themselves. I'm grateful to them. Many people just talking about gossiping, everything in a different direction to just backlash on the Indian companies. That is not right for us. We don't deserve that. And I think H1N1 then, Ebola, a good example, Ebola vaccine was never completed a human clinical trial at all when Merck developed. WHO has done emergency authorization to do it in Liberia and Guinea, and those countries have done directly into the human trial. And sort of affair. And 2014, the license came in. 2009, they started outbreak. And 2014, the license came in. So that means emergency license is allowed globally. It is a practice. Even US government says, if you have good immunization data, can be done in an emergency authorization. And I think, look at it, phase Merck Ebola vaccine, 39 subject and completion EMA 2020, they got November emergency authorization before phase three trial. Even Johnson & Johnson Ebola vaccine, only 87 people, they've done it. And they got emergency license in 2019, and they're done in Rwanda immunization program. It is allowed. people are not just, I don't know why Indian companies always targeted by everybody in the world. We are not a company without a vaccine experience. And I think we have tremendous experience in vaccines. And that is what I want to highlight that. And we have various product portfolio, which I'll touch upon a little bit, but not important. But we are not just restricted to COVID, but a lot of other programs are there. And I think, you know, we're touching 123 countries globally. So it's very important for us. What we do in India is a reflection of the globally also. It's very, very important for us. It's a brand image of India, brand image of Bharat Biotech are critical for this serving this public health of these 123 countries globally. And I think we are the only company, I can categorically say, has got extensive research experience and extensive publication peer-reviewed journal. Many people say that I'm not transparent in my data. I think people should have patience to read internet and look at what our articles are and how many articles we publish. More than 70 journals, 70 articles have been published in various international journals, one of the top journals in the world. Nothing less than that. So I think that's very important. We are better than even an academic institute of a country of this country in India. And I think we are extensively positioned in the public review. We have more than 400 to 400 patents. That shows our innovative capability of a company that we stand by today representing the developing world in a public health point of view. We are proud to say we partner with a public-private partnership with NIV and ICMR. Many people question, we have not validated our assays. Truthfully, we have all our samples. We validate with NIV Pune. We send a sample, blind sample. We write that data and we give it to them and they analyze and they send back the data. We double blind studies, we have done it and we validate both of us assay. So because these assay cannot be done in non-BSL-3 containment. Many people question unnecessarily, oh, we're not validated assays in other part of the world. It is not required because in a BSL-3 containment, only place we can use the live virus into the place. The live virus cannot be used in any other facilities. So when you are using live virus, it has to be done properly, scientifically, and that. So our method is validated by NIV Pune. Please note down that one. It is people questions are wrong what they're spreading the news is on that. Fact. And we have platform technology, more than 300 million doses of viral cell culture platform we produced. Whether it is injectable polio or COVID or Zika, chikungunya, rabies, Japanese encephalitis, rotavirus vaccine, which is the largest selling product for us. And all these vaccines are produced in viral cell culture. It's the most proven platform, the safest platform in the world. And I'll just tell you that many, I don't want to, it's a very confusing slide, but we put all transparently every data when we submitted to each committee and when we got the approval, when we had done the trial, everything is put in the plan. People question, oh, we are not transparent. I don't know what is transparency to me when I put everything in the black and white like this. People still question transparent because Indian scientists are cheap people. You can throw the stones on them on anything you want to. And that is a problem. And I think, you know, people ask, oh, we don't have any data public domain. In a public domain, it takes in 6 months, 7 months, when the vaccine going in a fast track clearances, we are also under pressure. And we published, we are the only company published five articles. I'll give you an indication on this. BSL-3, we are the only BSL-3 production facility in the world. We are proud to say that even US government doesn't have, UK government doesn't have BSL-3 production facility. They have a lab, but not a production facility. I'm proud to say that India has got BSL-3 production facilities. And we are here to help any of the public health emergency of any part of the world, in the world, that we are ready to help them, anybody in the world.